But like the magic number is somewhere between 8 and 9.
That's good.
And I'm gonna drink my Dr. Pepper. Okay.
Feeling these pH levels. Let's get it. How much does a regular water bottle have?
I don't like 2.
Oh shit, that's not
I don't know, I just made that up. And welcome everybody, this is the Film Glutton, and you are listening to DC Gluttons with Carlos.
What's up, sweaties? Let's get to the pH levels, let's go!
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Okay, we are talking DC Universe.
DC Universe. The streaming service that they're going to have.
The
and the shows
service.
That they announced. Yes. We got a couple. We got some. I'm more excited for the animated series and the Teen Titans. But I want to hear what you think on Young Justice.
Okay, we'll get into that one second. Yes. Let me just update everyone because it launched on Thursday. Thursday, we heard the Snyder Cut movement news with the Wall Street Journal, and we heard that was the one side of the coin. This was the positive side, though.
Yes.
Because it was live. You could now pre-order. The website itself is not, you can't watch stuff, don't get too excited, but you could pre-order. And if you pre-ordered, you had to buy an annual membership. There was no monthly payments. So this is informative for anybody who's thinking about it.
Yeah.
We got 2 extra months free. So we got 15 months. Okay, don't have the quote exactly in my head. I didn't write it down. I believe it was 76 and change I paid.
That's not that much. That's actually a pretty good deal.
No, so it breaks down to, especially with the extra 2 months, that breaks down to like $5 a month.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You're the college kid now. You're the smart one.
I don't know.
Do that math.
It's like 16. No, I'm just kidding. So what? But that's $76, right?
$76 for 13 months.
For 13 months or 15 months?
15 months.
15?
Yeah, yeah. I'm throwing curveballs.
Wow, man. That's really good. That's $5.
$5. I just did that. I'm a human calculator, everybody. I might be the smartest man alive. I might be Mark Zuckerberg. You don't know. You don't know.
Let's get to DC. Okay,
I'm sorry. I'm distracted. So we also both got entered into the chance to go to the Aquaman premiere.
Yes, 2 I'm so tickets. Hyped.
So we are DC Gluttons are officially DCUs.
Yes,
DCU Gluttons.
You think we'll get press passes?
Oh, of course.
Absolutely. Yeah.
I mean, I think how so could you not? Especially if Mark Zuckerberg is hosting the show. Gonna not give it to Mark Zuckerberg. Maybe I shouldn't say that right now. He's in the hot water.
Yeah. You gotta check out the daily. All right,
You gotta check it out. Normally it would just be 12 months for about the same price, so yes. That's still a great deal that breaks up to like 6 and change or whatever. But check it out right now, the promotional campaign. It's amazing. There's a bunch of stuff. There's the shows that we're gonna get into. The reason why I figured it was still worth it no matter what is because of the comic books,
right?
It does say new and old, so I'm very excited to see what they have. Like, I will sometimes wait for a year for the trade to save some money. Mm-hmm. For like Injustice, I don't buy right away. I wait for the trades. So I'm hoping that something like that, just a year behind or something.
Yeah,
so,
that's a good idea.
But we're going to get all, as soon as that hits online, we will be doing shows about it. I will be exploring it, and we will be bringing that knowledge to you guys, or sharing the knowledge if you are doing it too.
Yes.
Now, so the news. Let's get, there was Young Justice trailer.
Right.
That's going to be on there.
What'd you think?
I'm intrigued.
I'm intrigued too. It's the animated, right?
It's the animated.
I kind of like it. I'm liking that they're doing that. They actually have a huge slate of animated series. We'll get to that a little later. But I like it. I like the Young Justice. I like the whole idea of it. I'm pumped. I'm excited. I'm curious to see where it goes.
I got to tell
what
you
are your thoughts.
I got 2 thoughts. First off, I was super pumped.
Yes.
Because it totally reminds me of the Young Justice I fell in love with. 2. I need to rewatch Young Justice because
it's been a while for me too. Yes.
It's been a really long time. So before I do anything, maybe we'll just do a special DC Glutton show of us rewatching them and then talking about it, because I did get super pumped. There's a lot of information like that's kind of thrown at you with
right.
Kid Flash and all sorts of stuff. But yeah, I mean, big stuff was happening, but I don't know. I definitely was like, I need to rewatch it
again. Yes, I was thinking the same exact thing. That's definitely on the agenda.
It was 5 minutes.
I know.
It wasn't just a trailer. It was 5 minutes.
Well, The Walking Dead, don't forget, they gave us a 5-minute trailer.
I didn't see that. Season 9.
Yeah, it was okay. But yes, but that was awesome.
Yeah,
I actually really liked it. I'm pumped for it. I can't wait.
Okay.
I can't wait to get into it.
Right?
Yes.
Okay, so as soon as it's on, we're going to rewatch it. We're going to rewatch the old ones and watch the new ones.
Teen Titans is what I was most hyped for.
That's it.
I was super hyped.
Right into Teen
Titans. I loved it. So I loved it. You know what? I loved it that they focused a lot on Nightwing, but I don't know if you've ever seen The Signal. The guy who plays it is Brent I'm going to put his last name, but DeWaits, and he's actually the person that's playing Nightwing. I like him as an actor. He's a really good actor, and I know the big controversy is he was like, F Batman. I love that. I love that because that's what makes Nightwing, what makes him great is the fact that he still has this resentment and this animosity towards Superman, towards Batman, and he wants to kind of carve out his own path in Bloodhaven.
Yes.
Which is super exciting.
That's it, right?
Yeah. Well, what I like too is that, and they're kind of showing a little origin story of Dick Grayson.
Yeah.
Because they have that scene right there in the beginning where he's at the circus.
Well, I know people are saying, there's haters and lovers about it.
Right.
I enjoyed it because it conveyed one concept of exactly what you're talking about. In just a few words, it conveyed, this is Nightwing. This is the Robin that needed to prove himself. Yes, it's not exactly the Dick Grayson we fell in love with. Dick Grayson is kind of different, but they just, in a couple of lines, they needed to get out that it's this stage of Grayson.
I like that
because
actor.
He did have a huge chip on his shoulder. He didn't talk to Batman forever in the comic books.
Years.
Yeah, so like I say, it's true to the comic books in terms of the era they're going for in that way. Right. Yes, could they go too far with this? Yes. Was it because they knew it was going to just flash and catch you right away, you know? Like,
right.
Sure. But then there's also, like, but it, in just a few lines, it captured who Nightwing was. And then you had all these the tone I love about it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm surprised at how dark they're going with this. I mean.
I love it.
I thought, is this DC Dark? Is this, like, the label they're going for? You know? But it looked really good. It had a little bit of scary vibe in it. And to make a comparison I probably shouldn't make to Suicide Squad. No, I do not think it's going to be.
It kind of did have that vibe.
I don't think it's going to be Suicide Squad. But do you remember, like, when we first saw Enchantress? Even if you hated that film, when Enchantress is called and her hands flip around from a human to a darker Enchantress, and you just saw her image, people were in love with that. You can't tell me that wasn't creepy and cool. That's the stuff I was getting from this. So it visually was so compelling. It gave me just exactly what I wanted. No major story things, just saying, look, this is the character you're going to get that you're going to want from the comic books.
Right.
And these are some of the visuals that you're going to want. It's going to be super awesome.
I love the visuals it gave us. It gave us Raven, it gave us Beast Boy, and it gave us Starfire. I love the way Starfire looked. And Beast Boy. Beast Boy didn't even have his green skin. This is what gets me so excited for this Titan trailer. I think it was just called Titans, but what's great about it is that it's this trailer represented clearly identified how different it was than the CW universe.
So that's it. That's all the stuff that was released for the DCU. If anybody was at Comic-Con, go and leave in the comments that if they went to the DCU experience, because I did read a lot about that. I'm not familiar with it though, because I wasn't down there.
They did release the animated slate as well for the DCU original animations. One thing I do want to kind of throw out there, which gets me excited, they're going to release in 2019, is The Reign of Superman, Justice League versus The Fatal Five. Super hyped about that one. And then Wonder Woman, Bloodlines. And then my favorite one, which they already have an animated about. It's not an animated series. It's an animated, I think it's just an animated the movie. They're making a Hush one as well. So that's my arguably one of my top three favorite storylines in the DC.
Oh, so good.
In DC. So I'm super hyped because we all know DC animated series.
So quick thoughts.
It shows. Knock it out of the park.
So which one are you most pumped
Hush.
About?
Hush? Absolutely. Hush. Because it explores the darkness of Batman in a sense that it's ties all the way back to his childhood. It was his best friend growing up, and he has no idea. And when he realizes that it's his best friend, the surgeon, who's been doing all this
and killing
these people. Or was it him? Sorry, I got way too into it.
No, yeah, that's all right. Go read the comic books.
Yeah, read the comics even better. But yeah, when you just start seeing, and Batman has a kind of a crisis of consciousness, that moment.
So good.
When you can explore more possibilities with Batman and kind of have him in a little bit of crisis that he's not used to, that's what makes it great. And Batman has that in these comics, in the series, and I can't wait for the animated series.
My quick thoughts, I just got to share. The one I'm most excited about has to be Reign of the Superman.
That's pretty awesome.
Because that's the 13-year-old boy in me being super excited. Hush came out. I was already an adult. I loved it.
Yes.
Super good. But I was a matured adult by that point in time, so I enjoyed it at a different level. So there's a little bit of... I'm going to get more and more excited, and I will 100% buy Hush, and I will watch it, and I will love it, and I will rave about it. But That should have been the film. Because as soon as you're done reading that last page of Hush, there are so many books that you pick up and you're done reading with No Man's Land that you're just like, this needs to be a Batman movie. Get on this, you know?
Yeah.
And then they do it. Dark Knight Rises. Or a version of it. But Hush should be its own movie.
I couldn't agree with you more. We will get to that. We will get to that.
The Red Hood, the problem is Red Hood, I really wanted it as its own movie, but we already got Winter Soldier. So give us, we want Hush live action.
Yes, give us Hush. Come on, Reeves.
Reign of Superman, I'm like, I read that.
What about the Fatal Five?
That'd be interesting too. I mean, that's all going to be really, really good.
Yeah.
But I think Reign of Superman, because again, I had that trade paperback. It was thick back in the day. That was a lot of comic books. And it was not that necessarily good. Story, but you just loved it so much because you're like, which one's gonna be Superman? Which one's gonna be Superman? And since you ruined Thomas, I'm gonna say none of them are Superman.
My bad.
That was such a disappointment in life. I mean, it was cool to see him come back. Okay, guys, we're ending it right there. This is the Film Glutton reminding you to never turn down an upgrade. Have a good night, folks.